students, I am Dr. Sakshi Arora Hans, your Obs and Gynae faculty. And today I am here for my FMGE students. So, FMGE students, your date of your exam has been declared and you know it's 31st of August. And I know that all of you would be very scared and nervous. There must be so many questions going on in your mind right now. How to study? What to study? This is just 1.5 months left. How to revise the entire course and how to best utilize this 1.5 months. Now, so that you don't waste your time on planning, I have chalked out a day-by-day plan for you, which if you follow, your entire syllabus would be complete with revision, one revision also, and with grand tests also in this 1.5 months. I'm going to share with you a unique strategy to prepare for your exam in this 1.5 months, and that strategy is the 3-meal plan strategy, right? It's a unique strategy. The 3-meal plan study strategy. Right? Now, before I start telling you that how this strategy works, how you are going to follow this strategy and what is this strategy, one thing I want all of you to do, and that is to stop presuming that the date of your exam will get postponed. Stop this discussion right away. The date of your exam will not change. It is 31st of August and it will remain 31st of August. Right? So, the date of the battle is final. Battlefield is ready. Everyone is getting ready for a big battle. So, what are you waiting for? You also have to get ready for this battle. But you have to fight. None of you are going to say that I am not prepared for this August FMGE session and I'm going to appear for the December session. None of you. All of you are going to go prepare and you are going to sit for this August FMGE session. This is one thing which you have to decide right now, that you are going to fight this battle. Clear? Even if you are starting your preparation now, still it's okay. Follow the strategy which I'm going to tell you. Give your 100% effort and leave the rest to God. So from now on, your focus will be on clearing the MCI screening test. That's your bullseye. And in order to do that, you are going to shut yourself from the outside world. Now, when I say this, I just don't simply mean social distancing. I mean, you are going to practice social media distancing also. When I say you are going to practice social media distancing, it means no WhatsApp, no Facebook, no Instagram, no Telegram for this 1.5 month. Clear? Second thing, you are not going to run around looking for more matter now. You are going to stick to one set of notes. Now, in each subject. Now, that notes could be your coaching notes. It could be the notes which you get from Maru or from PrepLadder. Stick to one source of information and just believe in that. Do not run around for looking for more books and more notes to put in your bookshelf. This is not the time to do that. Stick to one set of notes and just keep on revising that notes. See, you just have to clear an exam. You are not focusing on getting a rank here. So your clearing of exam, it can be done by just following single notes and by becoming a jack of all trades, master of none. This is what you have to keep in mind. You don't have to become a master of one subject. You have to become a jack of all the subjects. Clear? Now, let's move on to the three meal plan study strategy. Now, what is this three meal plan study strategy? In this strategy, you are going to divide your day into three slots. Like, you have three major meals in the day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Similarly, your timetable is going to look like a three meal plan. The first slot will be your breakfast slot, where you are going to study from 7 a.m. to 12:30 in the afternoon. Then the second slot will be your lunch slot, where you are going to study, that is the second slot. So it will be from 2 o'clock to 7 o'clock. And then there will be a snack time in between, where you are going to study from 7:30 to 8:30 in the evening. And then there will be a dinner time from 9 to 12. So three major meals and one snack will be how your day is going to look like. Now, when I say you are going to have the three major meals, during that major meals, that is between 7 to 12:30 when you are studying, when you are studying between 2 to 7 and when you are studying between 9 to 12, you can have a single half an hour break in between, or you can have 2 15-minute breaks, right? So your meal is ready. Now let's talk about your menu. This is how your menu is going to look from 11th of July to 28th of July. See, always our elders, they tell us that the heaviest meal should be your breakfast. Eat like a king during the breakfast time. Then eat like a rich man during lunch, and eat like a poor man during your dinner. Same thing we are going to apply to our study strategy. All the difficult subjects and the subjects which carry the most weightage, we are going to do them in slot number one, that is your breakfast slot, between 7 to 12:30. So from 11th to 28th, in the breakfast slot, you are going to do surgery, PSM, and obs and gyne. So I'm repeating, from 11th to 28th July, in the breakfast slot between 7 to 12:30, you are going to revise surgery, PSM, and obs and gyne, giving 7 days to each of these subjects, right? Then, in the lunch slot, that is between 2 to 7 p.m., you are going to study pharma, physio, and micro. Again, you are going to give 7 days to each of these subjects, right? Then in your snack time between 7:30 to 8:30, I want all of you to do MCQs. 1 hour of mixed bag of MCQs from all the subjects. It's just a random questions from any subject. And when you are doing this MCQ, this time, this particular 1 hour, you are just going to read question and answer, question and answer, right? During this 1 hour, 50 MCQs where you are just going to read the question and the answer, right? No explanations to be read in this 1 hour. And then comes your dinner slot. Now your mind would be a little exhausted. So we are going to do subjects which are the minor subjects and which carry a little less weightage. And this is the time when you are going to do ENT, forensic, ophthal, and biochemistry, giving 5 days to each of these subjects. Right? So breakfast time, we are doing the subjects which carry the most weightage. And surgery, PSM, obs, gyne together are going to constitute around 90 to 100 questions. In the lunchtime, you will be doing pharma, physio, micro, giving 7 days to each. And these three subjects together constitute around 35 to 37 MCQs. Then in the dinner time, ENT, forensic, ophthal and biochemistry, and these constitute around 25 to 30 questions in your paper, including paper 1 and paper 2 I'm talking about, right? So by 28th of July, the subjects which you have done, they are going to carry a weightage of 150 to 170 questions. Right? So till 28th of July, I know I have done the subjects which are going to carry weightage of 150 to 170 questions in your exams. Now, one very important thing which I want to tell you here is, none of you are going to leave any subject. The schedule which I have given you will incorporate all the subjects, and you are also going to study all the subjects. You are not going to think that I'm going to leave this subject. No. Do the subject. Even if you cannot do it that well, do it. Right? Now, on 29th of July, you are going to assess yourself by giving an online grand test. This is very, very important. You have to give a grand test. If you do not do that, you will not be able to handle all the subjects during your exams, no matter how well you are prepared. And please do not postpone giving grand tests. Do not procrastinate. Giving grand test is very, very important. At this time, you cannot think of not giving a grand test. So give a grand test to yourself on 29th of July. Now, when you are giving a grand test, these are the three things which you are going to note. Number one, you are going to, yes, assess yourself. The grand test is there to make you assess yourself, right? Number two, in the grand test, now this grand test, what I recommend is, whenever I say that you have to give a grand test, it should be a previous year MCI paper. Now, when you are giving a grand test, after you have given the test, assess yourself, then read the topic from which the question was asked. So, all the questions, whatever topic from the question was asked, you are going to read that topic in the remaining day. And third thing, just now I'm going to tell you to make a notebook which will be called as the LMR notebook, the last minute revision notebook. I'm going to tell you what the purpose of that notebook will be. But in that notebook, one thing which you are going to note is, you are going to note the question with the correct answer in the form of a single line. So your grand test is going to be a previous year MCI paper. After solving the grand test and after assessing the areas where you are weak, you are going to read the topics from which the question was asked. Make notes of those topics in this LMR notebook, which I'm going to tell you. And all the questions, whether it was a correct answer given by you or whether it was incorrect, all the questions with the correct answer, you are going to note in the form of a single line. After doing this much, if you still have time at night, on 29th of July, you are just going to have a quick look at the instruments which are used in surgery and in obs and gyne. Just quickly go through those instruments. Now, as far as the obs and gyne instruments are concerned, I'm going to make a video for all the important obs and gyne instruments and post it here on YouTube, or I am going to give images of the important obs and gyne instrument and post it on my Facebook page, the Obs and Gyne Updates by Dr. Sakshi. Clear? So this is how you are planning till 29th of July. So the first half of the menu is ready. Now let's talk about the second half. Now, your menu from 30th July to 10th August. From 30th July, you in the first slot, that is your breakfast slot, from 30th July to 5th of August, you are going to do medicine. For medicine, you are getting 7 days. Now, how are you going to divide those 7 days in medicines? 2 days you are going to focus on cardiovascular system. 2 days you are going to read and revise the endocrine system. 2 days for GI. Last 1 day you are going to keep for respiratory system. In respiratory system, you should know pneumonia. Then you are going to do tits and bits from the CNS, that is the epilepsy and stroke. See, I am not telling you to do medicine completely. Why? Because out of the 30 questions which you get in medicine, if you have revised micro, pharma, physio, and patho, you will be able to solve 15 questions. And by doing cardiovascular, endo, GI, again, you will be able to solve another 8 questions. So this should be your target. Medicine is very vast. So do not do a lot of medicine, right? Stick to cardiovascular system, endocrine system, GI system. From respiratory, stick to pneumonia and a little bit of the central nervous system. In the renal system, what is important is nephrotic syndrome, which you can cover from pathology as well. So when you're going to do pathology, you are going to do nephrotic syndrome. You are going to do nephrotic syndrome from in your pediatrics as well. So renal system is one system. If you don't have time to revise, if you have done it already and you have time to revise and you can incorporate the renal system in these 7 days, that's fine. But if you do not have time to revise, forget about it, right? Then, from 6th of August to 10th of August, you are going to focus on revising pediatrics in the breakfast slot, right? Now, let's talk about the lunch slot. From 30th July to 5th of August, you are going to do pathology. 6th of August will be for anesthesia. 7th and 8th, you are going to do skin, and 9th and 10th, psychiatry. Right? So, in the lunch slot from 30th to 5th, you are going to focus on pathology. 6th, you are going to do anesthesia. 7th and 8th, skin, and 9th and 10th, psychiatry. Then, in the dinner slot, from 30th to 5th, you are going to focus on anatomy. 6th to 9th, on ortho. Now, once you have done anatomy, ortho also becomes a little easy. And once you have done ortho, radiology becomes easy because most of the questions on x-rays and radiology are asked from orthopedics. So, on 10th, you are going to do radiology. So, this is how you are going to prep, plan your preparation till 10th of August. Most of your subjects are done by 10th of August, if you follow this study plan, the 3 meal study plan strategy. Now, I was talking about the LMR notebook. While you are revising, right, when I am telling you at this subject you have to complete that subject, whatever subject you are completing, whatever important tables are in that subject, you are going to note them in this LMR notebook. Whatever important one-liners or concepts which you feel that I'm going to forget, you are going to note in this LMR notebook. Mnemonics, you are going to note in that LMR notebook. And also, when you were practicing MCQs, that 1 hour snack time which you have from 7:30 to 8:30, which is going to be throughout. From 11th of July to 10th of August, every day between 7:30 to 8:30, you are practicing MCQs. One thing which I forgot to mention here is that between 30th July to 10th of August, now your speed will increase. You will be in a habit of practicing MCQs quickly. So from 30th July to 10th of August, increase your speed rather than doing just 50 MCQ. Target 100 MCQs in that 1 hour. If you are able to complete 100, that's good. Otherwise, you will come to 70 to 80 MCQs. Right? Now, when you are practicing these MCQs, you are going to write this MCQ in the form of a single line, that is the MCQ with the correct answer in the form of a single line. For example, suppose the MCQ is Vasa Previa is seen in option A, a battle door placenta, option B, succinturate lobe, option C, placenta bilobata, and option D, velamentous insertion of the cord. So since the correct answer is velamentous insertion of the cord, you are going to write this MCQ like this. Vasa Previa is seen in velamentous insertion of the cord. Single line, in the form of a single line, you are going to write this MCQ in the LMR notebook. Why I'm telling you to do that is because when you are revising the entire subject, you are focusing on understanding the concept. But while you are doing these MCQs, you are focusing on making a habit of doing the MCQ. That's one. Number two, your focus is that just in case you get a single liner question, you don't do any mistake in that question. Right? Concepts are cleared during your main revision time. While you are doing MCQs, if it's a clinical MCQ, that's a different thing. But if it's a single liner MCQ, you are going to note it in your LMR notebook so that you can revise it later as well. Right? So this is how your study plan will look like till 10th of August. Now, on the 11th of August, again, you are going to give yourself a grand test, and again, you are going to follow the same rules. The grand test should be your previous year MCI paper. In the grand test, you are going to assess yourself because now your entire syllabus is complete. You will assess yourself that which is your strengthening area, in which subject you have more confidence and you are answering much better, and in which subjects you are lagging behind. Number two, again the same thing, whatever question has been asked from whichever topic, you are going to read that topic and you are going to note important points of that topic also in your LMR notebook. And third thing, you are going to note the entire paper in the form of a single line question and answer in the LMR notebook. The rules for grand test remain the same throughout, right? So on 11th of August, you are going to give a grand test again, which will be your second grand test. Now you are going to start your revision. On 12th and 13th of August, you are going to revise Obs and Gyne, and simultaneously you are going to revise ENT. As far as Obs and Gyne is concerned, what are the important topics on which you have to focus? I will be making a video and I'll be releasing that shortly. On 14th and 15th, you are going to revise surgery, and along with surgery, whenever you are tired of doing surgery, you are going to revise your biochemistry cycles. And again on 16th of August, you are going to give a grand test. Now, whenever you are going to give a grand test, that entire day would be gone, because in the first half, you'll be giving a grand test. In the second half, you'll be reading important topics from where the questions were asked. Right? Then, on 17th and 18th August, you will be revising your PSM, the community medicine, along with psychiatry. On 19th and 20th of August, on 19th August, you will be giving a grand test, and by now, you would have come into a habit of giving grand tests. So now it's going to take a little less time. So on 19th, you will give a grand test. You are going to do the same things what I told you earlier. And on 19th, whatever time is left after giving grand test and after preparing your notes on that grand test, you are going to start revising pharma, which you are going to continue till 20th of August. Now, when you are revising pharmacology, your focus should be on antimicrobials and on the central nervous system. 50% questions from pharmacology are asked from these topics, right? Then, On 21st of August, again a grand test, and whatever time is left after preparing, after giving grand test and after preparing your notes, you will start revising anatomy, which you are going to continue till 22nd of August. Similarly, on 23rd August, you are going to give again a grand test, and on 23rd and 24th, you are going to revise microbiology. Physiology is going to be done on 25th of August, and pediatrics you are going to revise on 26th of August. Now, after 23rd August, I do not want you to give any grand test, because after 23rd, if you give a grand test and if you do not score well, your confidence will shake. On the other hand, if you score really well, you are going to become overconfident. So after 23rd August, no giving of grand test. Right? Now, what are you going to do in those last 4 days? In those last 4 days, 27th, 28th, 29th, and 30th, you are just going to do chanting. Now, when I say chanting, I do not mean that you are going to chant a Gayatri mantra or you are going to chant Hanuman Chalisa. No. By chanting, I mean that you are going to pick up the LMR notebook. You are going to read each and every line what you have written in that LMR notebook loudly, right? Revise your LMR notebook cover to cover between 27th to 30th, right? That is all what you are going to do between 27th to 30th. Loudly, you are going to revise again and again. You know, if in 2 days you complete your LMR notebook, the next 2 days, again, you are going to revise your LMR notebook. That's all what you are going to do. So your LMR notebook is very, very important. That is your golden points. That will become your golden points for FMGE exam. There won't be any need to purchase any other golden points if you make your LMR notebook properly during the time when you were revising your subject, right? So 27th, 28th, 29th and 30th, you are going to just revise your LMR notebook. So this is how you are going to plan your this 1.5 months. So I have given you a detailed day-by-day strategy of how you are going to plan this 1.5 months. But bachcho, execution of this strategy is in your hands. And I know all of you can do it. What you need to do is you have to jump from the seat next to the driver's seat on which you are sitting right now and come to the driver's seat. Hold the steering of your preparation. Accelerate your preparation and take it to the finish line. All of you have the capability to do that. 1.5 months from now, either you can have a 1.5 month of progress, or you can have a 1.5 months of excuses that why you couldn't. And I want all of you to be in the first category. I want all of you to clear your MCI exam so that I can teach you and prepare you for OBS and Gyne for NEET PG. I want to meet all of you in my classes or through the Marrow app for the PG preparation. Now, you tell me whether you want to meet me for PG preparation or not. And for that, first, you have to clear your MCI exam. I'm always available to you, not only as your OBS and Gyne faculty, but also as your mentor. As far as OBS and Gyne is concerned, I'm going to shortly release a video on YouTube on my channel. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel and to press the bell icon on the important topics which you have to do for FMGE. Although OBS and Gyne is a very, very important subject, it has around 30 to 35 questions come from OBS and Gyne. So I would want you to do entire OBS and Gyne in those 7 days which I have allotted. But still, if you are unable to do, first you are going to focus on the important topics which I will tell you. Also, on my Facebook page, that is OBS and Gyne Updates by Dr. Sakshi Arora, on my Facebook group, that is FMGE OBS and Gyne Discussion with Dr. Sakshi Arora, on my Instagram handle, Dr. Sakshi Arora Hans, I will be posting important images which you need to do in OBS and Gyne for your MCI exam. If you have any queries, you can also join my Telegram group. So, all the best. Keep studying smartly, and be safe. Thank you. God bless you.